All right, everybody, it's been a golden week, and the Bone Finder showed up. I'll tell you all about it right now. Here we go. All right, everybody, there has been some gold found this week. And this is one of them right here. The Gigmaster hit a nice gold chain with an emblem on right there. Ah, let me get it off here. Oh my goodness. Ah, a little tight on me. But anyway, it's a beautiful gold chain. Check it out. I'm loving that gold right there. I did actually go out yesterday and got 3 rings. I went out today and got 5 rings. So we have been hitting some pretty good beaches here lately. Tell you real quick about, well, let's talk about gold. We're talking gold. The one today, right there, is a nice ring. The diamond on it is not real, but I did acid test it. It's not marked, so I was saying, it's not going to be real. It's not going to be real. But it did hold 14K acid, 18 ate it right away. It tested acid good, but I tell you what I am going to do. My friend at the refinery has a machine, a spectrometer. It's about a $25,000 machine. And you can put this in there and it will tell you 100% what's in this thing, every metal. So I will be taking it there, but right now it's saying gold and that's what we're saying it is. I did get today also this right here. I thought it could be gold. Looks pretty nice, right? But I scratch tested that and that, it held for a second, but then it ate it away within 30 seconds. It was starting to eat it away, so I'm saying that right there is not gold. I did look for the chain. Anytime you find a pendant, always look in the hole. I actually took an extra scoop at the hole, looked at it and all, because you know there was a chain on this. It had to be. Okay, back to yesterday, the 3 rings. I did find this one. This is a huge, huge ring. I thought it was a college ring. It's designed like one, but what it is a 100-year anniversary ring for a fraternity that apparently this guy belongs to. And that thing's huge too. But anyway, it's got a name in it. So hopefully we'll be able to find him. I've not been on hometown yet, so kind of a strange name. It's not John Smith. But anyway, I thought it'd be easy to find him, but I have not found him yet. But I know the attorney. I should be able to get up with them and try to hopefully track him down and get that right there. So that's pretty good. And I have seen another big gold chain found. Some other rings. I mean, it's summer's here. The depositors are deposited. But you might go down there and spend all day and not get a thing. I mean, I know my friend went down there this morning and he didn't get anything. So, I mean, you don't know. It's a hit and miss sometime, but then you might find a little pocket and find 3 or 4 rings within a 5-foot area. I mean, it's strange how that shifts some of the targets around sometimes. Heavy target, look for those heavy target areas too when you got some steel and you start getting that. I usually keep my iron on it first, you know, so I start hearing some iron in the area. That's the area I concentrate on. But anyway, yep, keep beating up with the beach. If you put enough time in, you're going to find the gold. The Bone Finder, he showed up, and actually I was on the beach when he showed up, and we hunted on the beach for a little bit. Then we went the next day and hunted another beach a little ways away, and he hit a 14 karat gold real diamond ring. Congratulations, Bob. That was first target. His first target at beach was a 14 karat gold ring. But anyway, we then actually did do some cemetery mapping. He had a job out here to do, and he actually mapped the cemetery, found numerous unmarked graves in that cemetery. And I got a chance to actually use the ground penetrating radar. He said, yeah, he had to do some else. Take it, go run with it. And he'd already showed me a little bit about it, so I was able to go over and recognize the bird bodies and recognize some different things. Tree roots, he learned the difference between different things while you're using that ground penetrating radar. So I did get a little lesson from Bob. Appreciate that, Bob, for a little bit of lesson. I'm probably not gonna buy one at 25 grand, but at least it was a very educational time for me to do that. So we had a great time doing that. He actually told me a story about he actually dug a grenade. I talked about last week about a guy that did that, but he actually was in the field scanning, you know, and actually actually, he was pushing the ground penetrating radar. He didn't actually detect it. And actually, the ground penetrating radar, I guess it was sticking up above, there's a little thing that goes underneath of it, grabbed it and yanked it out of the ground. He looked at it, and he knows he was in Vietnam. He knows what that looks like. So he said, that's a, you know, Vietnam era hand grenade. And he actually called the local authorities and they got it and detonated it, and they said it was live. Where'd it come from? He found out that there was actually two planes crashed in that area and threw all kinds of debris everywhere. They were finding pieces of motors and all, but they did drop, I guess, some ammunition and some grenades and stuff. And he found one of them, pushing that and yanked it up. Strange and unusual finds. If y'all got a story you want to talk about, let me know. Send me an email, gigmaster2718@gmail.com, and I will talk about it here. Appreciate that. Let's talk about Chris. Y'all know Chris is back in Vancouver, and he's doing all kind of recoveries already. I mean, he hit the ground running when he got there. You know, when you talk about Vancouver, you know it's cold up there, right? You wouldn't think it'd be that many beaches there. That's in my mind anyway. I said, beaches in Vancouver? He can send us another video of another beach right here. Check it out.
Hi, it's Chris Turner. A shout out to the Gig Master, Stephen. How you doing? This is third beach in Vancouver, British Columbia, my hometown. I just made a recovery. It literally took me less than a minute. It was my second target. It was a fast one, but look how beautiful this beach is. And it's just gone 11:30. There'll be way more people on here a little later on. Absolutely love this beach. It's been a nice place to come and detect and help people. Thank you everybody for watching my videos. You wanna watch that YouTube one, it will be on theringfinders.com. That's theringfinders.com on YouTube. Thank you everybody, have a good day.
That's one of the beaches he recovered, an awesome ring one. I'll put a picture up there of the video. You can actually see that video where he recovered that ring on the Ring Finders on YouTube. What I'll do, I'll put a link in my video description that you can click on and go right straight to that video, and another link that you can go straight to his channel. He's got tons of stuff on his channel. John Cryer from 2.5 Men, he found his ring. That video's on there. That's pretty cool too. But anyway, go check Chris out and show him some love. Give him a couple of likes. But I tell you something else I'm going to be doing. I'm going to start giving something away every week, for right now anyway. And right now, the first thing I'm going to give away this week is $18.97 right there. I got boxfuls of coins I found everywhere. So I'm going to start giving some of them away. They're just sitting there collecting dust. I'm not doing anything with them. So, $18.97, just put a comment down below. You don't have to say anything special this time. Maybe in the future might, but right now, as long as you make a comment below, you're going to be in the drawing next week. It's 50 cent right here. All right? And we're going to try to do something each week and start giving some stuff away. So stay tuned for that. Now, I do have some rules for my giveaways, and it's down in my video description. You can see the list of all my rules. You got to be not U.S., a bunch of different rules. You got to share, you got to like my video and all. Anyway, that's down in the rules are down in the video description down below. So check that out. I do appreciate everybody clicking my Amazon links to help me out and promote my channel. I appreciate y'all that are on my crew that help donate a little bit each week to kind of support my channel. All that helps me out. I appreciate it. All right, sounds good. I think that's going to wrap it up. I appreciate everybody coming along. Don't forget to click like, comment below, share. Subscribe to the Gig Master. And we'll see you next week, and we'll find out who won. Stay tuned.